After Oliver Cromwell's death in 1658, his son attempted to carry on his reign, but the people and Parliament rose up in defiance and demanded the restoration of King Charles II and all the freedoms that implied. They wanted the taverns and theatres reopened, and they wanted a restoration of the halcyon days of the Stuart monarchy, in which champagne had flowed, food had been plentiful, and the arts, theatre, fashion, laughter and larks had reigned. On King Charles II's birthday, 29th of May 1660, preparations had been completed. Accompanied by his mother, the Dowager Queen Henry, and 20,000 royalists who'd shared his exile, King Charles II was restored to an overjoyed London. The bunting was hung, the banners of the Royal Guild swaddled the buildings as royalists rode triumphantly through the streets in a never-to-be-repeated outpouring of love for the liberties of royalty. For a full fortnight, the fountains flowed with champagne, the bells, which had been silenced by Cromwell for over a decade, pealed, and the people of London sang and danced in the streets wearing the finery forbidden by the Puritan military dictatorship of Cromwell as they cheered their joy at the return of their Stuart monarch. People hung from the windows and crowded on rooftops to get a better look at the resplendent sight of the royal court and in all its magnificence and the beauty of the eccentric parade of characters riding along, including the remarkable scientist and anti-vivisectionist Margaret Cavendish, her husband, the greatest Cavalier of all, William, Duke of Newcastle, and the subversive Lady Elizabeth Wilbraham, the world's first woman architect. No one could bear to sleep or miss a moment of this fortnight-long party to celebrate the return of joy to the kingdoms of Britain. After over a decade of Cromwell's dark reign, which had forbidden colourful clothing, music, jewellery, makeup, or laughter, it's easy to imagine the thrill of Londoners at the sight of their merry monarch and his colourful court returned to them, riding resplendent through the streets in a whirl of music, bells, and singing. The Stuarts' return to St. James's Palace also marked a return of gaiety and wit to the kingdoms and an end to piety and oppression. Women were afforded new freedoms in all areas of society, including the ability to act on stage in public. Maypoles were returned to the centre of village life and taverns and theatres reopened. Once again, cross-dressing was legalised and people continued to celebrate the 29th of May as Oak Apple Day until late into the 1800s.